Good morning, students. A very warm welcome. Let us start a new topic, Purchasing Power Parity Theory. This is in Module 4, Lesson 3, Purchasing Power Parity Theory. And the question on this topic can be explain or critically evaluate Purchasing Power Parity Theory, in short, Triple P Theory. So there are two parts in this. In the first part, we are going to discuss absolute version, and in the second part, relative version. So let us start with absolute version. Purchasing Power Parity Theory, Triple P, was developed by Gustav Kassel. This theory explains the determination of long-term equilibrium exchange rate based on the price levels of two countries. The Triple P theory is based on the assumptions. Number one, there are no trade barriers between countries. Second, the price index for each of two countries must comprise the same basket of goods. Third, the concerned goods in the two countries must be identical in every respect. Next, all the prices should be indexed to the same year. And the last, the law of one price prevails. That is, identical goods should sell for the same price in two different countries at the same time. The first part of the theory, the absolute version. The theory has two versions, absolute version and relative version. According to the absolute version of Triple P theory, the identical basket of goods in the two different countries must sell for the same price when expressed in the same currency. For example, if a basket of commodities is sold at Rs. 140 in India, the basket of identical commodities sell at $2 in USA, then the exchange rate expressed as price of $1 in terms of rupees will be Rs. 140 is equal to $2, so Rs. 70 is equal to $1. The exchange rate is equal to the ratio of the price index of the basket commodities in the home market to the price index of the basket commodities in foreign market. Let us understand this. It can be expressed as R is equal to P upon P square, where R is exchange rate defined as domestic currency units per unit of foreign currency. P is price index of basket of goods expressed in the home country, expressed in the domestic currency, for example, India and in the rupee as respectively. P star, price index of an identical basket of goods expressed in foreign country, expressed in the foreign currency, say for example, USA and the dollar respectively. From the above example, the rate of exchange can be expressed as R is equal to 140 divided by 2 is equal to 70. Hence, $1 is equal to rupees 70. If there is an inflation in India with no price change in USA, the new equilibrium or new exchange rate will be rupees 150 by 2, that is 75. That means $1 is equal to 75. On the other hand, if there is a price rise in USA, there is no price change in India, then rupee will appreciate in terms of dollar. Let us say that after 1 year, the basket of commodities in USA cost $3 instead of 2. With no price change in India, the new exchange rate will be 150 divided by 3 is equal to 50. So $1 is equal to 50. Now, criticisms on absolute version. The absolute version measures the absolute level of internal prices. This is the first criticism. The second one, the goods produced and demanded in two different countries cannot be of the same kind and quality and therefore cannot be compared in terms of their prices. Third, the selection of basket of commodities may not be done objectively. Fourth, there are several difficulties involved in compilation of the price index numbers. Next, according to the theory, there is a functional relationship between the purchasing power of the currencies of two countries and their exchange rate. In reality, there is no such direct and precise link between two. Next, capital account transactions are not taken into account while determining the exchange rate. Students, for this convenience, I divided into two parts, but when the question is there that explain the or critically evaluate PPP theory, you have to give both the version. We completed absolute version. In absolute version, you have to give entire details like this. Thank you very much.